Kristen, Nico, and now Hudson, and they're going to introduce their piece.
Genghis Khan, formerly known as Temujin, was a warrior and ruler of genius, who started from obscure and insignificant beginnings, brought all the nomadic tribes of Mongolia under the rule of himself and his family in a rigidly disciplined military state. He then turned his attention toward the settled peoples beyond the borders of his nomadic realm and began a series of campaigns of plunder and conquest that eventually carried the Mongol armies as far as the Adriatic Sea in one direction and the Pacific coast of China in the other, leading the establishment of the great Mongol Empire.
Renaissance may be considered a modern classic, the underlying themes of the French Revolution may be lost in its mainstream. Despite the fact that Viva La Vida is Coldplay's highest charting single, many fans fail to recognize the central idea of the song and ultimately the album. Viva La Vida, the song in the album, is a retelling of the French Revolution and the death of King Louis VI.
Thank you. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer is a fictional reindeer created by Robert L. Rudolph is usually depicted as the ninth and youngest reindeer of Santa Claus history, using his luminous red nose to lead the reindeer team and guide Santa's sleigh at Christmas Eve. Though he intentionally receives ridicule for his nose as a fawn, the brightness of his nose is so powerful that it illuminates the team's path through the harsh winter weather.
Rodolfo, el Red-Nosed Reindeer, es un reno ficción creado por Robert L. May. Rudolph generalmente se representa como el noveno y más joven de los renos de Santa Claus, usando la luminosa nariz roja para liderar el equipo de renos y guiar el reno de Santa Claus de Nochebuena. Aunque inicialmente reciba burlas por su nariz de cervatillo, el brillo de su nariz es tan poderoso que ilumina el camino del equipo a través del duro clima y en el mar.
Es parte de un género de música de Europa. Which is
used the signature Hendrix chord in the mix, the blues and eastern valleys shaped by the novel sound processing techniques. Because of ambiguities in the lyrics, listeners often interpret the song as referring to a psychedelic experience, although Hendrix describes it as a love song.
Purple Haze es una canción escrita por Jimi Hendrix y lanzada como el segundo sencillo de Jimi Hendrix Experience. El 17 de marzo de 1967, la canción presenta su famoso toque de guitarra, que utiliza el acorde característico de Hendrix y una mezcla de blues y modernidades orientales, formado por novedosas técnicas de procesamiento de sonido. Debido a las ambigüedades de la letra, los oyentes suelen interpretar la canción como una referencia de la experiencia psicodélica, aunque Hendrix la describió como una canción de amor.
So we have the team of Catherines. So if you guys could stand up. Thank you so much for assisting me.